much, Andy. Now, I've been waiting all show for this. It's time to meet the guy who stars in a new documentary on Monday night, BBC 4, 9 o'clock, called Swim the Channel.
Oh, brilliant!
What do you think is that? I've got my trunks on as well.
I've sort of established a role as a grand old man of channel swimming. Somebody asked me how many times have I swum up and down Dover Harbour, and it must be hundreds, thousands. And now all of a sudden I'm just sort of playing at it.
Please welcome to the show Kevin Murphy. Now, you're nicknamed King of the English Channel. Do you know, I've been so looking forward to chatting to you about this. Why on earth did you do it in the very first place?
As the clip you showed just earlier said, I was the tummy little kid who wasn't very, really good at cricket or football, but I found my niche. I could be good, I could be better, I could be the best at endurance swimming. And the kid who was down the pecking order was suddenly top of the pecking order, and I wanted to prove something. I wanted to prove something to myself. Nobody else, just to myself, that I could be good.
OK, so the very first one that you did, at the end of it, can you remember what that feeling was like?
There was a feeling of exhilaration.
Yeah.
Quickly followed by never again.
Yes, OK, never again after the first one. How many times have you swum the channel now, King?
Well, 34.
Yeah, OK, so never again.
But the point is, it's so obsessive. It's such a... You have to give so much to it. That never again is followed about 10 minutes later by, oh, what next?
And have you done the backwards and forwards?
I have, yeah, two widths.
Oh, my word. How long did that take you, then?
Well, I've done that three times. The first
six
time...
Six times?
No,
not backwards and forwards like that.
Yeah, three... I've done a two-way on three occasions.
Oh, I see. I thought you meant you did it six times.
I did try three-way once, and I got within 6 miles of doing it. I swam for 52 hours non-stop.
How do you do that?
Just keep awake.
No, but seriously, I mean, all jokes aside, trying to stay awake is quite one thing, but while you're swimming for 52 hours... How do you carry on? What's going through your mind?
You go into a zone, a dreamland. An hour will just seem like 5 minutes. And basically, it's willpower. While I'm in there, I hate it.
Do you?
It's a sort of an act of will, not to... The salvation's a touch away on the boat.
Do you talk to yourself?
Yeah, I say all sorts of things to myself, mostly along the lines of, whose stupid idea was this? And I get into it. But that's the point, because if you can overcome all these frailties, overcome all these demons in your head, the satisfaction of actually getting there, doing it, achieving it, is enormous. You feel that you can do anything. You can beat anything.
Do you know what you've said? There's a part of me that I'm completely hypnotised by you and thinking, should I?
Yes.
Should they? But I'm not a very good swimmer. I mean, if somebody's not a good swimmer, could they swim the channel? Because it seems to be, it's a mental thing.
It is. It's more mental than it is physical. I say it's 50% willpower, 25% swimming ability, 25% fitness. So the more, the fitter you are and the better swimmer you are, the less you have to draw on that willpower. But it's willpower overwhelmingly.
What a pleasure it is to meet you. Are you going to do it again?
I would love to. I've got a problem at the moment. I've too much swimming. I've got a metal shoulder.
Oh, goodness me. OK, you be careful then, and don't do any of these things that we're about to do. Thank you.
But I haven't given up on it.
Good. Well, lovely, lovely to meet you. Now, we couldn't get a swimming pool into the studio, of course, to learn the perfect swimming stroke, but we do have the Swimbeam swimming machine, a new product on the market being used by top athletes and Olympians. And Jamie, lovely to see you. So excuse me, I'm going to walk around this way, Kevin. Means I get to... you stay there. Means I get to put my hand on your shoulder. Now, you've developed this machine, Jamie, to aid professional swimmers, haven't you?
Well, really for everybody. So swimming's a difficult sport to get good at. You know, it's quite technical. And if you want to get up to swimming the channel, let alone shorter distances and so on, there's a lot to put together and takes time. You've got to get down the pool. You've got to learn how to develop your stroke while you're breathing and staying afloat. So with Swimbeam, what you can do is supplement your pool training.
Can we see you absolutely. Do it? That's probably whilst you're explaining.
Yeah. So what this lets you do, and it's unlike any other piece of gym equipment, is you're replicating the biomechanics of swimming. So you're building muscle memory of a proper swimming stroke. You know, you're in exactly the same position, and you know, you've got all that sort of full reach at the front end of the stroke, positive catch, high elbow.
You're not kicking.
Yeah, I can kick as well. What you'll find from someone like Kevin is that actually the leg energy is a small part of the stroke, and most of it's coming from the upper body.
Oh, I didn't know that. Thank you for telling me that.
So, you know, you've really got to develop your lats, the big swimming muscles down
the
back.
Come on then, you two. Now, we've got two people who are going to try out the swim beam. Tanya and Matt. Matt is very worried about this, aren't you?
Yeah, I don't like water, so this is
really
scary.
No, there's no water for me. What I do is doggy paddle.
So. Yeah, you doggy paddle.
I doggy paddle.
And you say you're not a great swimmer. Go on then. Both of you, pop it on there. Pop on there.
Okay, so if you grab those black
handles.
We're going
to do three different strokes.
And just lie down and start off with your hands in the kind of start position. So up.
Okay, we're going to do the crawl first of all.
We might start with breaststroke.
Oh, breaststroke. Oh, apologies.
Okay, so just pull both arms down to the side, okay?
Oh, it looks fun.
And then back in.
What does it feel like, Tanya?
Actually, this feels like swimming is possible.
Oh, really?
So if you really want to maximise your stroke, you're going for those high elbows, and it's more of this. You're using all of that to push
think,
the
Kevin?
Water behind.
So keep the elbows
don't
up.
Don't do that.
Like
that. Don't do that.
Yeah, right, like,
do that.
Like,
that
like the man says.
That way.
Yeah,
okay.
Not the
no,
arms
you don't,
out.
You don't go around like that.
Oh.
You go...
That way.
Yeah, so it's that. You're getting high elbows and pushing...
That's
pushing
in the trough. He's like just doing so. He's doing his own thing there. What's the next stroke we're going to
okay,
do?
So let's have one arm out in front and just leave it there. And we're just going to work on the arm that's by your side. So one arm at a time. So forward it comes and just leave one arm there. Oh, well, you're on it anyway. Okay, so let's freestyle.
How's this then, Kevin? King Kevin?
What you've got to be careful of is that you don't pull through like that. You have the elbow...
Elbow up.
Elbow forward. When you're pulling back, elbow forward.
So your arms like this, otherwise you're pushing the water down instead of behind you.
Oh, that's good. Okay.
Yep.
Right, so one last. Can we do butterfly very quickly to finish off?
Yeah, absolutely. So butterfly, you know, pretty much the same as breaststroke. Both arms, full extension and scooping all the water behind
Tanya, you.
So,
you never
again, elbows up high. That's it. You're dropping your arms a little bit there, but there.
Oh,
there you go.
I'm feeling it.
You're feeling it.
I'm
good.
Feeling
thank you very much, Jamie. Right. Thank you so much for coming. You two just carry on swimming then.
Thank you,
Kevin.
He's getting it on the.
He's getting it.
I'm winning.
Yeah. And you think I'm winning? How lovely. Thank you. Keep racing. Keep going. After the break,
speed.
No, don't stop. After the break, one of our guests, JB, Tanya, or Andy, will go up against Matt. Don't stop swimming. In today's Better Than All Right challenge, Matt beat champion boxer Audley Harrison last week. Okay, the question is, which one of today's guests should take him on to help them decide? Here is a clue. And that's the clue. Carry on. Find out if JB or Andy, whoever it's going to be. Plus, Michelin star chef Daniel Clifford teaches us all the secrets
elbows
to his
forward.
Herb. God, keep swimming.
Oh my God.
Keep swimming. Keep going.